Hey everyone, we just want to welcome you to 7 on the 7, and we're just here to encourage you during this time, to give you just encouragement from God's Word, to let you know that as a church, we're walking you through this and walking with you, and we're just here to help you with God's Word, but most importantly, God is walking through you with this, and we're just here to encourage you. So I want to start off today out of Acts chapter 8. And it says, on the day a great persecution broke out against the church in Jerusalem, and all except the apostles were scattered throughout Judea and Samaria. Godly men buried Stephen and mourned deeply for him. But Saul began to destroy the church, going from house to house. He dragged off both men and women and put them in prison. Those who had been scattered preached the word of God wherever they went. Philip went down to a city in Samaria and proclaimed the Messiah there. When the crowds heard Philip and saw the signs he performed, they all paid close attention to what he said. For with shrieks, impure spirits came out of many, and many who were paralyzed and lame were healed. So there was great joy in the city. You know, it reminds me kind of today, you know, this outbreak happened, this pandemic happened, and it wasn't anything different than what the first church experienced, just in a different way, that this pandemic of persecution just broke out. And they were going to buildings together, they were going to houses together, and God disrupted again. And so, but the encouragement here is the church didn't fold up. They didn't stop being the church. They didn't say, oh, well, let's just give up because a persecution broke up. They found new ways to do ministry. And this is what I love about it, is they went into a movement. And I believe that's what's happening today. And there's a meme on social media that I love, and I posted it. It said, although the church doors close, the church isn't empty. The church has been deployed. And so we have been deployed to reach out to new people in new ways to get the gospel out. And that's exactly what is happening, not just the city church, but churches in our community, churches around the world. And there's a couple things I want to show you in the scripture that God did to push the church out into a movement and scattered them. And the first thing that happened is the gospel went out. It changed lives. And so that is still our call. Even during this coronavirus, our call is to still go out and get the gospel message out to the lost. And the second thing is God moved in many ways, that signs and miracles started happening. And so God's doing that right now and moving in so many different ways. And the thing that I love the best is great joy happened. They didn't let the persecution defeat them. They didn't let the persecution bring discouragement. They didn't let that enemy just come in and wipe them out. They moved and joy happened because they saw God move in a different way. And it's always through a crisis that God moves in these mighty ways. And so I just want to share real quickly with you of what's happening right now in our world, of how God is moving. And actually, I believe that the church is actually becoming stronger and more powerful during this time. And so I just wrote a quick list, and I want this to encourage you and to not give up and just, you know, sit at home and do nothing. But I want you to pray to God and say, God, what can I do during this pandemic? What can I do to reach out? And here's some things that are happening in our world. The first thing, revivals are breaking out everywhere in our world. A great example is Brazil. I mean, Brazil is just catching the fire of God, and amazing things are happening with the people of Brazil. Doctors and nurses are on their knees praying in the middle of hospitals for their COVID-19 patients and seeking God for healing and wisdom. That is incredible. When's the last time we saw that, where revival was breaking out in hospitals? Online attendance has exploded in churches. You know, we're always worried about attendance and getting people in, but here God has switched us around and said, no, get the message out. And though the pews might look empty, though the building might be empty, the attendance for churches aren't empty. God is doing a new thing here. And I've looked at not just our attendance online, but a couple of more churches in our area, and their attendance online has exploded too. So online attendance for churches is exploding across the nation, across the world. Other things are happening. Our church is doing this. Is churches are opening up their food banks and pantries to where they're feeding the poor. And they're like, look, this is our part that we can do in this pandemic, because the supermarkets aren't always full and you can't always get the food. So churches are opening up donated food so that people can get the supplies and food that they need. And that is a fantastic thing that churches are doing. Other things that are happening is people over the world are seeing praise and worship out their windows. And we see this in Italy. We're seeing this in Brazil. We're seeing this in parts of our nation. They're not stopping the worship of God. They're proclaiming it in the streets. And another amazing thing that happened is you'll look at the rooftops of hospitals and you have medical staff praising and worshiping and praying on the rooftops of the hospitals. Another thing about hospitals are Christians are coming to the parking lots of hospitals and they're praying over the hospital. There's been an explosion of Bible studies and prayer groups online. And so I want to encourage you, church. The church isn't dead. The church is still moving. This might be a persecution from a virus, but it's not stopping. And one of my favorite memes out there right now is, "Watch out, devil. The church has left the building." So let me pray for you. Let me encourage you this time. Father God, I pray for the body of Christ. I pray for the church. God, this isn't a time of defeat. This isn't a time to just pack up our bags and say, look, we give up. No, God, this is a movement that you are doing by your Spirit. And God, it is exciting for the body of Christ right now, because God, you are moving in your Spirit in mighty ways, in revivals, in getting the gospel message out. You're moving in miracles. And God, we are encouraged by what you're doing. So I encourage every Christian and everybody part of the body of Christ, God, continue to bring that fire in them and teach them, Lord, new creative ways to get the gospel message out. And grant us peace during this time, but let us be a movement that changes this world. In Jesus Christ our Lord, amen.
Hey guys, Pastor Tim here from City Church of the Treasure Coast. Thank you for joining us tonight for 7 on the 7. We're here every night for you to bring encouragement to a world right now that needs the love of God. I want to ask you to do something for me, as hopefully you've been touched by tonight's broadcast. Will you please go to citychurchtreasurecoast.com, citychurchtreasurecoast.com, and click on the Donate Now button and give the best gift that you can so that we can continue to feed our community, to bring hope to the world, and to share the gospel with all creation. If you'll give a gift today of $25 or $50 or more, it'll help us to touch a life for all eternity. I want to thank you in advance for going to citychurchtreasurecoast.com and giving that special gift tonight. God bless you. We love you, but God loves you more.